Pedro Avera live in Coloma to tell us more about the city's history. Pedro, last time we saw you, you were inside of an old jail.
Yeah, I was, and now I decided to get back on track. I had to get out of jail. I decided to come to school. This is the Coloma Schoolhouse here. There's so much history in this ghost town. It's really just a town that's just chock full of history. Again, this schoolhouse is really cool, especially when you see inside of it, because not only do you have just amazing stuff in here, you have amazing people as well. We have Diana Kelly with Camp California and Jerry with the California State Park. So tell us why Coloma and why people should come out.
Well, this segment was all about ghost towns. And although Coloma really is more about the historical aspect of this town, but this is really where California began. This is where gold was found, and this is why we are all here.
Perfect. And now you see this schoolroom here. There used to be first graders sitting over there all the way to eighth graders. And you can see the differences in the desk. To tell us more about it, Jerry, with the California State Parks, there's a lot of history just in this room alone.
There is a lot of history here in this school. This building here actually was put up here in 1920, but there were schools here in Coloma beginning in 1850. The original school was actually in the county courthouse, which, like we talked about, the county seat moved to Placerville, so then they used the courthouse for the school. That building actually burned down in 1919 on a Friday, and unfortunately for the kids, on the next Monday, they were in school over at the IOOF hall, so they didn't get a break.
No days off.
No days off for that one. This building actually came from over near Kelsey. It was a school that wasn't being used there, and they took it all apart over there, brought it over here on the wagons, and put it all back together.
So the kids would actually have first graders through eighth grade here, and one thing Jerry told me is that they would take the first graders, seat them all right here, right? All the other kids were doing their independent work, and that's when the teacher will teach them, and then send the first graders and second grade, but, you know, yada, yada, yada. That's what they would do. I mean, this is really just an amazing town, and like Diana mentioned, a place where California was founded, really, with the gold rush.
Yes, it is. This is where it all began. This is what made California become a state so quickly because of the gold rush and all the people that came in for that. We have a lot of other historic buildings here in the town that you're welcome to come out and view.
Perfect.
A lot of history here, a lot of fun things to do.
So, Diana, really quickly before we go, where can kids go to learn more, especially if you want to bring your kid here, if they're maybe celebrating a birthday or something?
Right, exactly. So the Coloma Resort here in town actually hosts about 15,000 kids every year to teach them more about history and Coloma, including my daughter Lily, whose 15th birthday is today, and she's celebrating at Oak Creek Training Stables with all of her friends and her horse.
Nice.
And more information? camp-california.com.
Couldn't have said it better myself. Happy birthday. And also come out and celebrate Coloma. It's a beautiful place, guys. I'm about to take a lesson right now. I brought my apple for the teacher, so I think I'm going to be doing okay.
Oh, shoot. Teacher's pet.
Oh, let me get the bell, too. I can ring the bell, too. Look at this.
Hey, Joe, you're having so much fun out there.
Ring the bell.
School's in session. School's in session.
All right, Camp California, thanks for showing us around Coloma. 942, the best bang for your buck. Nissan, roll.